the world premiere of Shotgun Wedding. Are you ready?
Estoy lista. Uno, dos, tres.
Oh my God! Okay, that was way
too much. What the hell is
this?
Hola a todos, my name is Gabby Cam, and in case you hear a funny accent here, that's because I flew all the way from Mexico City to be at this premiere, and how's that for an arrival?
And I'm Mac Wall. I don't know if you just saw, but we just arrived on Zipline to the world premiere of Shotgun Wedding. You look so calm, cool, and collected. How are you doing that?
I'm not. I'm actually faking it pretty nicely, I think, right?
Yeah.
But I'm excited.
Well.
I am really excited about this premiere. I mean, who doesn't love a wedding? It's supposed to be one of the most memorable days of your life, but I think for Jennifer Lopez and Josh Duhamel, it's going to be memorable for all the wrong reasons, I think.
And we're here on Hollywood Boulevard. We've shut the street down for the last 3 days. We have a helicopter, we have a boat, we have a zip line that you just saw us come in on. And in a matter of minutes, we're going to be joined by the cast and crew, including director Jason Moore, Steve Coulter, Desmond Borges, Selena Tan, Callie Hernandez, Cheech Marin, Darcy Carden.
And listen to this, Lenny Kravitz, Jennifer Coolidge, Josh Duhamel, and of course the one and only Jennifer Lopez. This is going to be full of surprises, and we are going to make sure you don't miss a thing. We have people in every single corner of this red carpet, so you don't miss anything.
We are covered all over the carpet tonight. We have an action cam, which will be the zip line, limo cam, fan cam, fashion cam, chopper cam, and even our very own boat cam.
This is the world premiere of Shotgun Wedding. Bienvenidos a la premiere mundial de bodas de plomo. I am Gabby Cam.
And I'm Mac Wall. Get ready for a night to remember as we meet the cast and filmmakers of Shotgun Wedding right here on the green carpet. Let's go check it out. And we're here with Callie Hernandez. Callie, tell us about what you've seen at this premiere so far. Are you so excited to be here?
I literally just got here and got out of the car. So I see a boat, I see you, and I see all you guys.
What are you so excited for audiences to see at the world premiere of Shotgun Wedding tonight?
So many things. Romance, comedy, action, Jennifer Lopez, Jennifer Coolidge, Josh Duhamel, Darcy Carden, Steve Coulter, Selena Tan. I mean, the cast is incredible.
What was it like on set working with this incredible cast?
I mean, like, kind of surreal, you know? I don't really know how I got here, but I'm so happy to be here and truly feels like a family, and it's great. I feel good.
Where did you film, and what was it like being on this in this incredible place, but also you're stuck in a pool for a lot of the film?
Yeah, I mean, we are fully clothed in a pool for most of the film, I would say, at least most of us. We filmed in the Dominican Republic, and it was beautiful and an interesting time to be filming. It was right when COVID was still happening, but it was like right when things were starting to kick off again, and It was lovely and interesting, yeah.
Fabulous. And can you say hi to all of our fans from around the world?
Yes, I can. Hi, fans from around the world. Enjoy.
And so there's literally, people are watching from around the world right now. What are you most excited? What is this film all about? And how would you like describe it to your mom or your best friend?
How did I describe it to my mom and my best friend? It's a comedy. I mean, it's a rom-com, and I think it's about love, and I think it's about family, and hopefully it's just fun.
Fabulous. Well, thank you so much. Enjoy your time tonight.
Thanks so much. Nice to see you.
Can you put that closer? Yeah. Yes.
And you're actually married to Jennifer Coolidge in this film.
At the drop, the stars are starting to arrive. There are hundreds of fans on the green carpet, and I'm about to be joined by director Jason Moore. Oh, no, that was a fake out.
I love how your character is always recording. If we actually got to see what he recorded throughout this film.
Oh, yeah. I had my own clapper. I started feeling like I was a part of the crew. And at one point, they were supposed to shoot something from his point of view, and the cinematographer said, no, Steve, that's my job. And I was like, okay. Yeah, I shot everything.
Oh, you should try your own film.
Yes, actually, I could be like a director's or a Larry's cut.
Oh my God, what would it be like? I feel like...
I got everything. So.
I also have to tell you, because if I would have to choose between the mother and father-in-law, for me, my favorite ones would be you and Jennifer. Why would that be? Do you think your guys are better than...
Well, because we're from Michigan, and we're just normal, and we have no drama. Well, no, that's not true. We have a lot.
And there's drama everywhere. Come on.
We made a movie, actually. That's yes. Oh, yeah.
I love it. So, well, I want you to know that there's a lot of people from all over the world watching right now. We have people from Mexico, which is my country.
Okay, yo hablo un poquito de español, pero dice que bienvenido México y gracias por viendo esto.
Steve, I was not expecting this at all.
I lived in Colombia for 4 years, so estoy recordando unas palabras y olvidando muchas más.
You just made my day. Thank you so much.
Okay, pues, de nada.
Buena suerte. Diviértete mucho.
Gracias.
Thank you so much and have a great time. Bye.
Hey, it's Mac here at the Limo Drop, and we are here with director Jason Moore. Jason, tell us how excited you are to be here tonight. It's
so
spectacular.
Excited. It's huge. Look at all these people. Hey, guys. So glad to have everybody here and get the cast together again. I'm absolutely thrilled.
Tell us about this cast and what made you say, I have to make Shotgun Wedding.
Shotgun Wedding, when I read the first script, it was just like fun and funny, and it was kind of like an adventure romance that we haven't seen in a long time. And it is, it's an opportunity to get all this kind of crazy cast together, and we got an amazing group of people.
Tell us about your time on set. What was the vibe like?
You know, we were shooting during COVID, and it was like, you know, what's this going to be like away from loved ones? But we were in this gorgeous location, and the cast, the wedding party, all really bonded. They like lived together, had pool parties, dance parties, watched each other's movies, and did like inside the actor's studio interviews. They really bonded in it, and it was fun for us, and then also made it onto the screen, which is great.
How do you do that combination of heart, comedy, action, all packed into one? It's a delicate balance.
It is a delicate balance. You find the actors who know how to negotiate all those places, and then you kind of just play and turn the dials. But that was part of the fun challenge of the movie, was kind of making it feel fire on all those cylinders.
And a kind of tough question. What would you say is the key to comedy?
Surprise. And silence sometimes.
Timing.
Timing. Yeah.
Well, have a great time tonight. I can't wait for everybody to see it. Great. Thanks.
Callie Hernandez is in the house. How are you?
I'm good.
You're good. You look amazing.
Thank you. So do you.
Oh, thank you. We're kind of cold, but we're not going to say that on camera. Oh, I just did.
Oh, we just did. Oh, whoopsies. But I didn't do the zip line, and you did.
I did, and that was a crazy idea. But Callie, please talk to me about your character. I know you're the sister of the bride. How was it like to be J-Lo's sister? That looks like a crazy thing to be.
It's pretty crazy. I mean, yeah, I play J-Lo plays Darcy in the film, and I play her kind of a cut and dry younger sister, maybe a little bit of a screw up in the film. Okay. My character's name is Jamie.
I know. It's crazy. And I know you got to spend a lot of time in the water for this film. Can you tell me about that? Was it as bad as it might sound as I'm saying it?
We did spend a lot of time in a pool, fully clothed. However, I mean, we shot in the Dominican Republic, and we were in an infinity pool overlooking, it was whale season, there were whales jumping out of the water. I mean, I'm not complaining.
Yeah, I wish I would have been there.
Yeah, and I'm surrounded by, you know, some of the best people I've ever gotten to work with, so we had a blast.
I can only imagine. And, you know, I really have to ask you, how good of a bridesmaid will you be?
Okay, I just kind of did it. I think I'm pretty good. She's over there.
Okay. Oh, yeah, yeah. She's over there.
I think I'm pretty good. I like having a job at a wedding, okay, and not having to
just be there.
Do anything else? Dancing and jobs at the wedding is good.
Well, a job can be just like have fun, I guess. Yeah. I mean, what is that one thing that you love about weddings?
Love.
I love.
Love and, I don't know, I like that everybody kind of just cuts loose and can celebrate at the end of the night. I feel like there's rare occasions for that now.
Right, yeah, you're right. Are you a dancer at all?
I have done it before. I wouldn't say I'm a dancer, but I like to boogie.
But you have a good time.
Yeah, sure.
All right. Callie, thank you so much for stopping by, and I hope you enjoy your night.
Thank you. How was the zip line?
It was good. You should try it.
Should I?
You should try it. I'll clap from here. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's not that high. Okay. Guys, so I just learned that I can actually use my Spanish to pronounce Alberto Isaac's name. How does that sound?
It sounds terrific. So refreshing to hear my name said that way.
I can say it many times. Alberto Isaac, Alberto Isaac.
Yeah, that's me.
So tell us a little bit about Ace. I mean, he is such an important part of this resort. Yes. Tell us a little bit what attracted you.
Well, my wife and I own this resort hotel in the Philippines, and my wife is a take charge woman, and I pretty much just go along and do what she says to do, and then we get invaded by pirates. Yeah.
Oh my God, that's crazy.
Right? Yeah. So we deal with it.
Yeah, there's nothing left to do. So how do you think you would do if you would have to deal with that in real life? Do you think you would stay cool or just no?
Oh, my gosh. Fortunately, my wife is Emily Kuroda, okay, a famous actress, is also a very aggressive woman. Okay. And I would say, what would you do, Emily?
We're going to do what you say, Emily.
Yeah.
Okay, right. So, you know, Alberto, there's a lot of Latin people watching us right now. That's why I flew all the way from Mexico to be here. So do you want to say something to the fans who are going to enjoy this adventure pretty soon in Amazon Prime Video?
Oh, you are going to enjoy it so much. Tanto, tanto.
Oh, mucho. Oh, no. Tanto, it's also Spanish.
Oh, really?
Yeah, okay. It means a lot. Yeah.
All right. Well, you will.
Okay, so thank you so much for your time, Alberto, and enjoy your time here.
Thank you.
I'm here with Steve Coulter, who plays Larry. Can you tell us about your character, Larry?
I am the father of the groom, and I have the privilege of being married to Jennifer Coolidge in the movie, which is a hard job for anybody. It was wonderful. It's just like a ridiculous dream come true that you didn't know you had. So, yes.
And what surprises are you excited to share with audiences tonight?
I can't tell the surprises. There are pirates, and you can't lose with pirates. So there you go.
You heard it here first. You can't lose with pirates.
That's my new catchphrase. That's it. Yes.
Well, enjoy. Have a great time tonight. Thank you so much. I'll see you in a bit.
Bye, guys. Bye.
Desmond Borges, it's in the house. Ricky Silver, the best man. Desmond, you were just telling me you have Latin heritage.
I do. My father was born right outside of Ponce in Puerto Rico, and then my mother's family is Italian and Greek.
Oh my God, that's a great mix.
Yeah, a lot of good food.
Like, what's your favorite Hispanic item? I would say Latino food.
Oh man, well, arroz con gandules.
Oh my God.
Yeah, traditional salt pork at the bottom, pork loin, sofrito, sazon, you know.
You're just making me hungry right now.
Do they have any here?
I don't think so.
We'll have to make a call.
I know. Desmond, congratulations on this film. Can you tell us a little bit about what was your favorite part of working with these people, which is amazing?
Oh man, you know, I think the entire experience was probably my favorite part. I mean, if you imagine it was in early 2021 where everyone was still huddled up at their homes with their loved ones in a pandemic, and then all of a sudden we were invited to come to the beautiful island of the Dominican Republic to all hang out together, eat together, and shoot a lovely film together. So I mean, I don't think you can ask for something that was, you know, more beautiful and needed in that time of mass anxiety.
I mean, I'm curious whether or not you actually had to laugh at certain takes, because I don't know how can you stand like still when you have all of this going on around you.
Yeah, I mean, especially when you have Jennifer Coolidge and Steve Coulter together and just kind of going off the page and just delivering some beautiful, beautiful, really funny stuff. It's really difficult to keep it together.
And then we have Ricky.
Yeah, Ricky Silver.
Do you think he's an actually good best man?
I think he does the best job that he can, you know?
Does he?
He does. You know, Ricky's still stuck in this phase that he thinks he has to wear this mask of always saying the wrong thing at the wrong time to make people laugh. But really what he wants to do is open up a drawer at home, let the universe know he's ready to find the love of his life, invite her in, and watch Netflix and have a pint of ice cream.
Do you feel like weddings are a good place to find love? I'm not sure. I feel like everything is just stuck in the moment.
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, I personally didn't find love at a wedding. I found love somewhere else. But, you know, I feel like I know people who have found love at weddings, or at least found a good time.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what is that one thing that cannot be missing at a wedding? Obviously the bride and the groom, but what else?
Right. Well, I guess it would have to be a tie between great music and great food, right?
Yeah,
they kind of go together.
Have you ever been to a Mexican wedding? Oh. We are crazy people.
No. Tell me all about it.
Oh, my God. We even have, like, this choreographed dances and stuff like that. And they just give away props at the wedding. It's crazy.
And then people dance with the props?
Yeah. They wear hats and, like, this, like...
I love that.
We're going to have to invite you to a Mexican wedding.
Sounds good.
Desmond, have a great time at your premiere, and thank you so much for stopping by.
Appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Have a great time. Thank you.
Okay, so as we mentioned, there are people watching from all over the globe, and we want to hear from you guys. Tell us what you're excited to see at hashtag ShotgunWeddingPremiere, and let us know what questions you have for the cast and filmmakers. Oh, I see Gabby is over there with Desmond, or is it Jason Moore, director Jason Moore? Let's check it out.
Para todo el público latino que nos está viendo en este momento, Jason Moore, el director de la película, está con nosotros. Jason Moore, the director of the film, is about to talk with us. Jason, I don't know where to start. What was the one thing that worried you the most when you heard you were gonna do like an action rom-com film?
There's actually all these scenes where all the actors are in a pool, they're being held kidnapped, and I thought, oh no, this is gonna be really hard. Wet actors in and out. Turns out it was like being at a beach pool. They all stayed in the pool all day, had a great time. So the thing I was most worried about didn't come true.
Oh, that's great. That's a great scene.
Yeah, it was really good. Thanks.
And you know, you actually managed to put together an amazing cast. How was it like to work with them?
They are an incredible group of artists from all kind of different places, and they all bring such joy, and they bring their game. They love each other. They actually a lot of them live together and had a really good time bonding, which was great. Shooting a movie that's supposed to be about family and fun, they made it a lot of fun. I can't say enough about them.
I will actually ask you, did you find out anything you didn't know about them while working with them, maybe something unexpected?
Well, I had never met any of them. So
what?
So there's always just getting to know what somebody's like. I had Zooms with a lot of people, you know, but there's a lot of kindness and grounded authenticity in this group. There's some, you know, big personalities and everything, but there's a lot of kindness and a lot of heart, which also makes a better movie.
Can I say I feel that from you right now? I can tell you're kind and have a big heart.
Try.
Yeah, you do. And you know, I'm obviously Latina, I'm from Mexico. So I think I need to ask you, how would you describe the Jennifer Lopez effect? Because I think it's massive, isn't it?
It's planetary. I mean, it's like it's like gravity and out of this world and shining star. And also, though, extremely authentic and grounded and also kind. She wants everyone to succeed. It's kind of magical, and it's an honor.
Such an honor to get to see her on screen and you directing this. Thank you so much for the film, and I hope you enjoy your night.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
Have a great time. Thank you.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
Amigos, la dueña del resort está con nosotros, Selena Tan. Selena, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. I'm loving this vibe. It's really fun.
It's really relaxed, isn't it? Like, it doesn't really feel stiff. Everything is so chill.
Exactly. I feel like I'm a beachfront resort, filming the movie all over again.
Can you imagine what would it be like to actually have a resort? Come on.
Well, I had to imagine. Because in the movie, of course, I have a resort that they all come to, and then things go terribly wrong, but we rescue it in the end.
Oh my God. And Alberto just stopped by and he said he was always chill because he had you in charge.
I was always chill because I had Alberto next to me.
I'm scared. Like, I'm glad I wasn't there because apparently no one was in charge, or everyone was in charge.
Clearly, no one was in charge. No. I think in the end, both Jennifer and Josh were in charge because they really brought this movie right through to the happy, happy end.
Yes, of course. And for everyone who's watching us right now from all over the world, how would you describe the film? Like, if someone turns on the film, what will they find?
Definitely a rom-com, a lot of love, but very spunky as well. And there's a lot of action. So if you like action, I mean, really, there's a lot of action. So it's a film for the whole family. It's great.
And a lot of one-liners as well.
A very good one-liners.
I just want to say, like, I want to go back to Mexico and just say those in English. No one will understand it, but...
Oh, but I'm sure you'll make an impact.
I'll try to translate it. Selena, thank you so much for stopping by, and I hope you enjoy your premiere.
I will. Thank you so much for having me.
Have a great time.
See you.
See you soon.
Okay, so we're here with some Shotgun Wedding fans. Tell us your names. Oh. Okay, tell us your name and where you're from.
I'm Natalie. I'm from Chicago.
How's it going? So from West Hollywood.
Nice, right around the corner. And who are you most excited to see tonight?
Jennifer Lopez.
Jennifer Lopez, all the way.
And Jennifer Coolidge, and Lenny Kravitz, and Josh. Everyone. And the cast is incredible, so.
And do you know anything about this movie? Have you had any, you know, wedding horror stories?
My end, but I know it's filmed in the DR, which is so exciting to see.
Yeah, I've just seen the trailer, so I'm excited to see all the action, the explosions, you know, a little bit of the romance, so it should be a good time.
Fabulous. And what's the worst thing that you could possibly imagine happening at a wedding?
Oh my God, just explosion, ooh. Failure, who knows?
Wow. I know, I'm thinking like maybe getting stood up, like that would probably be the worst thing, right? Your partner not showing up.
Has that ever happened to you? Anything that would be surprising?
I'd rather not say.
Just stood up on a date, but that's it.
Be sure to check out Shotgun Wedding Premiere, #Shotgun Wedding. Yeah. Oh my God, look, there's Sarah. She looks incredible. I love that dress. So beautiful. Look how cute everybody is. They're matching suits. I love it.
Resort. Tell us a little bit what attracted you.
Well, my wife and I own this.
She looks spectacular. It's beyond. I don't even know how that dress is really staying on. She looks amazing. I told her that earlier. It's beyond. On the red carpet, getting his photo taken by all the paparazzi. We've got our fans in the back. It's pretty exciting. I love being here. There's so much action happening all around me. We've got all these influencers going down this zip line right now. We've got all these fans. We've got a boat over there. We are on Hollywood Boulevard. We've completely taken over you know, like five streets of Hollywood Boulevard here in Los Angeles, California. And it's really just so cool to experience it because this is such a fun movie. You're going to have this wild ride. There's so much heart and romance, and it's about this wonderful couple and then pirates attack. And it's totally unexpected. You never know what's coming next. And it's just really a fun ride that I cannot wait for all of you to experience and see what is in store for us tonight. And then on the 27th, when we see Shotgun Wedding on Amazon Prime Video. Okay, and I've just been told that we are about to get Lenny Kravitz, which is beyond exciting. I know the fans behind us are so excited to see Lenny Kravitz. Apparently, he has flown in on his private jet. And I mean, I would have loved to have been on that jet with him. It didn't happen, but we'll maybe get him next time. It'll be really fun. Oh my gosh, we have influencers on the red carpet in spectacular outfits. Look at that gorgeous purple one. It's just such an amazing time. I love being out, you know, we're getting back out into the world and everyone's having fun and celebrating such a fabulous movie that's, you know, it's just in time for Valentine's Day. It's definitely one that I'll go to the theaters to see. Okay, so we were just talking about the people that we're most excited to see, and over here we heard Lenny Kravitz. Tell us why.
Oh my God, he's a rock star. Are you kidding? Legend. I cannot wait to see him.
You were telling me about what you think he's going to be wearing. What do you think?
I'm hoping leather. It's going to be totally like rocker chic. Leather, sunglasses, he's got to bring it. So I'm so excited to see him.
Who are you most excited to see?
Jennifer Lopez, of course, you know.
What do you think she's going to be wearing?
You know, green Versace dress. No, I'm kidding. Right.
That would be amazing. And what do you think Jennifer Coolidge is going to have on tonight?
Oh, she's going to have like a beautiful gown, stunning from head to toe.
Jennifer is so exciting. Can you guys name maybe some of your favorite lines of Jennifer Coolidge? Do you have any in mind? Let's think about it. Who's got one? What do you got? Hold on. Here we go. We got one. It's the 4th of July. And I want a hot dog real bad. I knew exactly which one you were going for. What about Cinderella story? Does anybody know, what does she say? She says, the cucumbers in your eyes, they say, you don't look mad. And she says, oh, it's the Botox. I can't show emotion for another 3 hours. That's my favorite. What about Jennifer Lopez? What's a favorite film role of yours of Jennifer Lopez?
Oh my God, Wedding Planner is my favorite.
What is it about that movie that you love so much?
Everything, her childhood story from the beginning, how she just loved love, and then she grew up falling in love and just getting married herself in a small wedding.
I would say Jennifer Lopez is the queen of romance movies. They're just so perfect for this time of year. It's like, we're, you know, it's cold out. We want to cuddle up and watch a Valentine's Day.
Yes, it's perfect timing for Valentine's Day and love.
What do you think is your favorite Valentine's Day movie?
Oh my God, I love Jennifer Lopez rom-com, so yeah, Made in Manhattan, Marry Me, anything that she's been in, yeah, for sure.
And what's your name? Who else are you excited to see tonight?
You know, the whole cast, it's like so much fun, yeah. My name's Nick, by the way. Yeah, yeah. Thank you.
Where are you from, Nick?
Ontario, so not too far.
Not too far. How did you hear about this premiere? How did you all get here?
You know, I actually heard it through him, so.
Oh, tell me, how did you hear about it?
So I'm here for J-Lo personally. I'm the biggest J-lover here. I don't care what anyone says. Yeah, I almost pulled up in the green dress. Almost. But I don't want to match, yeah. But yeah, so like I heard of it on Twitters and I signed up and I got on the guest list and here we are now.
And who's we? Who are you? Tell us about how you got here and why you're excited to be here.
I actually had a lie to my boss for J-Lo, but I could always get a new job. I can't always come to a J-Lo premiere. And I came with my best friend. We had to harass people for tickets, and now we're here.
What happens if your boss sees this live stream?
Well, then I'm with J-Lo and you're at work, so have fun.
You're supposed to be at work right now?
Yeah.
What do you do?
I'm a supervisor at, yeah, I don't want to say I hate it.
I literally am getting her fired in this moment, and I feel terrible about it. She's like not even telling me. I am a supervisor. I do all the things, of course. I'm really sorry to your boss.
I'm not at all.
How long have you been at this job? You're with J-Lo, and it doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter. 5 years.
Oh, wow. Okay. Giving up a lot to be here with us. It's very exciting.
It's priorities.
And what are some of your favorite J-Lo roles?
Made in Manhattan, definitely. Her entire role in the Get Right music video.
Okay, I've just heard that we have Josh Duhamel coming towards us. Hopefully we can get him. He might head straight over to the boat. We'll see what happens. Okay, I'm watching. Let's see if we can get him.
How are you? How are you?
both of you. Tell us who you are and why you're excited to be here.
Paris Gibson here. Looking sharp. Look at this. Look at this, man.
It's the Shotgun Wedding Premiere. Anything can happen. Tell us why you're here and why you're excited.
Lenny Kravitz stand-in. You know, in the movie world, we call it second team. But no, all jokes aside, me and Josh, as y'all know, we got a bit of a history.
Oh, yeah.
We've done a couple things. You know, we the first one's on the other side of $1 billion for Paramount.
Is that
with
true?
It's true. Shia told me. But yeah. I'm here because I'm so proud of my brother, your movie, man. I love Jennifer, and Lenny is like my favorite human on earth. So I was just so crazy. I was just talking to Mike about you, man.
You were?
And Josh, tell us to the fans, what is this movie all about, and why should everyone be excited?
I'm sorry. What was the question? Tell
us, how would you describe this movie to fans at home?
It is. It's a big, fun, almost throwback sort of action comedy, romantic sort of big popcorn movie. That's the best way I can describe it.
And what do you think is the biggest surprise that fans will see tonight at the world premiere?
I don't want to give.
Josh is still handsome.
No.
I mean, it's true. It's very true.
I'm sure shoot this guy at any angle. Look at him. It's ridiculous.
You ever seen Lenny Kravitz cut into 1,000,000 pieces?
Okay, I'm so excited.
I would do it. I'm seeing it happens in the movie.
Oh, right.
You asked for a surprise. I gave you one.
Spoiler alert, I guess. All right, well, head in, guys, and have the best time. I think you're going to head over there to the boat camera.
I'm on my way.
So, guys, I'm really excited to introduce Darcy Carden in the house. Harriet, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm really excited to talk to you. And, you know, this is your night. Like, after all the work, after all these months or years or whatever it took shooting this, now you're finally here and you're going to introduce it to people. Yeah. How do you feel?
I'm so excited. It has been a while. It's been almost 2 years. And we've been excited to show the world what we did in the Dominican Republic. And you said, like, all this work. And for me, it was just, like, the most fun vacation with a bunch of cool people. And on the side, we did some work. So what you'll see tonight is the work that we got to do.
I mean, if you would have invited me, I would have gone happily not to work, too.
I know. I just met you tonight, though, man.
Right. That's good.
Yeah.
But, you know, I love this film. And I love your characters in such a peculiar state of mind. How would you describe Harriet?
How would I describe Harriet? She is, you know, she's like in her own little world, and she wants to kind of make, you know, everybody feel very like at peace and zen, but it kind of tends to do the opposite. You know, she's like tries to be a calming presence, and it makes everybody really irritated. She's not very well liked.
And is she like the perfect guest for a wedding? Is she?
No. But yeah, no, she thinks she is, but she is not the perfect wedding guest. Yeah.
Darcy, can you tell me what was your favorite part of shooting this film?
I mean, the cast, as you know, is like it's just the most amazing group of people. We came from all over the world into this beautiful location where we all lived together and got to shoot this amazing movie. And it was like, we fell in love with each other. It was like a real family. We had the best time. The cast, I am so excited to see everybody tonight. We've been sort of seeing each other today and last week at the hotel, and I want more.
Oh my God, you're gonna have a blast tonight. And before letting you go, I have to ask, if you were to describe expectations versus reality shooting this film, what was it like? Like, was it anything like you expected at all?
It was better. Because everybody got along so well. I knew the place was going to be beautiful. I knew J-Lo was going to be amazing. I knew Jason Moore was going to be a great director. But everybody just got along so well. It really was like, I feel almost bad. It was so fun. I know it was work, but it was just so damn fun.
You can tell you had fun. That's why the film is funny as well, right?
Yeah, it is fun. It's totally fun. You can like feel it. Yeah, for sure. You can tell.
And, you know, just so you know, there's a lot of people watching us right now from all over the world. I'm actually from Mexico, so okay. Is there anything you want to say to the Latin audiences who are also going to watch this film?
Oh, I hope you just have the time of your life watching it. We had so much fun making it. I'm glad you're watching it wherever you are. Enjoy. Thank you.
Woo. Enjoy your night, please.
them to see
it? I'm excited for them to see the whole world and everybody's.
Hi, Jennifer! So exciting. Tell us what fans are should be excited to see tonight. This is so amazing just to be here.
I'm excited to see it with an audience tonight. You know, when you see a comedy, it's always better to see it in the theater because you get everybody laughing and everything. So I'm really excited about it.
And what's unique about this action comedy that also has a lot of heart?
Yeah, it's funny. You know, I've done a lot of romantic comedies, but I've never done an action comedy. So it was actually a lot of fun. I don't know if you guys remember who Lucille Ball was, but I felt like I was getting my Lucille. You know what I mean? So it was, yeah, it was amazing.
What was the hardest moment, speaking of that?
The whole thing, it was amazing.
Hardest moment you had to shoot?
The hardest moment? Probably the zip line, you know, when Josh had to kind of, we had to fall off of it, and then he was like upside down, and there was a lot of moments, though. The car.
And you were tied together for a lot of the film.
The whole film. The whole film, we were handcuffed together, so. Yeah, it was crazy. It was fun, though.
Can you say hi to all of our fans at home and from around the world?
Hello, everybody. I love you guys. I love you. Thank you.
Love you.
Thank you so much. This is amazing. Have so much fun tonight. Oh, sure.
En este momento porque ya llegó el hombre del momento, the guy of the hour, Josh Duhamel. How are you?
I'm doing fantastic. This is unbelievable.
Do you ever get used to this, like, at all?
I haven't done anything like this for years. Amazon Prime Video did this huge.
Oh my God.
They really did.
Did you see that there's a zip line over there?
No, there's a zip line
there
here?
There is a zip line in your red carpet, right?
Yeah. We can all do that?
Yeah. I just did.
I'm going to do that.
Oh my God. So,
awesome. We're going to do the zip line.
Oh, my God. Yes, please. Please do. Dresses fly pretty nicely there. I did it.
Did you really?
I did. There's a video of me. But, Josh, congratulations on the film. Please tell me a little bit about this Tom guy who's pretty much a groomzilla.
He is definitely a groomzilla. That is the truth. He is somebody who is very excited about making sure that everything goes perfectly at this wedding. And you'll see very quickly it does not. So, you know, I think that's part of the fun of the movie is when have you ever seen a dude who handles all the details of a wedding?
I know, and he does everything, like everything is handmade. I love that.
Just like this boat, I made these right here.
Oh my God.
I made those. I was here earlier today.
I can only imagine. You have pretty beautiful handwriting.
Thank you.
So tell me a little bit about the boat, because you just told me that you have that back home. What?
So I have a lake in Minnesota that I spend a lot of time at, and this boat was something that was at the movie, and I asked them what they paid for it and would they give me a deal on it, and we ended up working it out. I have the actual boat from the movie at my lake in Minnesota.
Oh my God, that's amazing.
Yeah.
You know, obviously, this is an unusual mix of genres, I guess, with rom-com and action. Did you get to do anything for the first time?
Yeah, I've never hung 25 feet in the air with Lenny Kravitz. That was a first. Or J-Lo. It was just one of those movies that I had. I love Jason Moore. I love this director. He's got a really very specific sensibility about the kind of humor that he likes to put on screen. And it's a big, heightened comedy with a lot of action and a lot of romance, and I think that's what people are really gonna love. It's just a big old popcorn movie.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. And you know, I think we need to talk about the rivalry with Lenny Kravitz. Like, this is your time to stand for Tom. Why is he better than Sean?
How do you beat Lenny Kravitz?
That's very hard.
Beat Lenny Kravitz.
But if anyone is to beat him, it's you.
It's perfect casting, because if there's anybody that's gonna make a man feel insecure on his wedding day, it's Lenny Kravitz.
Is this a confession right here at all?
Yeah.
Are you insecure? Jealous.
I'm very insecure on that, man.
Oh, my God. You guys look amazing in the film. Josh, thank you so much for stopping by, and I hope you enjoy your night.
I will. Thank you so much.
Is there anything you want to say to Latin American fans?
I see Cheech down there. Hi, Cheech.
Hola.
Thank you. Have a great time.
All right, take care.
Bye-bye. Amigos, es momento de saludar a Jennifer López. Y en caso de que se lo estuvieran preguntando, guys, I have to say, yes, she is that perfect up close. Oh my God, come on.
Thank you, how are you?
I'm good. Jennifer, there's a lot of Latin people watching us right now.
¿Cómo están? Los quiero mucho.
Congratulations on the film. And you know, I need to ask you, what appealed to you about this story, not only as an actress, but as a producer as well?
You know, it just, I read it, and it's funny because I had just done a movie that was about a wedding, and it didn't seem like the perfect next thing to do, but I loved the script so much. It was so well written, it was so funny, and I just had never done an action comedy. I've done a lot of romantic comedies, but never a romantic action comedy, so I'm super excited to see it with an audience tonight.
And if there was...
It's a little chilly out here, that's why we're...
I know, yeah, I'm like this, I'm totally stiff. I'm like, yeah, I'm having a blast right now. But you know what? You are kind of like the sun. I have to say.
You are.
Oh my God. No one looks this perfect in this weather but Jennifer López. And you know, I have to tell you this because I'm Latina as well. I'm from Mexico. And on behalf of all the Latin people, you are an inspiration for us. And there are so many people looking up to you that want to be just like you. Is there something you want to tell them in case they're pursuing their dreams?
It's just never give up. You always have to kind of stay focused on the important things in life. You have to not let anybody tell you who you are, not let other people discourage you, and just know the power that you hold inside of yourself. Because we all hold this tremendous power that we don't know until we let it out. And then all of a sudden it's like, oh, everything's going the way I wanted it to. Once you start believing that it is. So it's an exciting thing to be here tonight for me because this is a dream for me. This is my dream.
Oh my God. And you're living the dream. Do you ever get used to this, to people really?
No, I don't. No,
oh my.
Always like the first time.
Yeah, I can only. Yeah, I can only imagine. And I also have to ask you, how did you build the courage to actually just step up and be who you are? Because I love that about you, how authentic you are.
You know, over time. I think when I was young, I had a lot of ideas and I was like, okay, I'm going to go for it. I'm going to do all these things. And then little by little, you get a lot of no's along the way. And you have to have a tough skin. You have to go, okay, you said no, and you said no, and you said no, and you said no, but you said yes. And then you're going to keep going. And you have to, again, that's where the belief in yourself is really, really important.
Jennifer, eres una inspiración. Gracias.
Yo también. Thank you so much.
Have a great time at your premiere. Jennifer López, la mejor del mundo.
Nice to see you as well. Thanks for being here. This is so cool. I can't tell you. So we're talking to fans from around the world. What is one thing that you want them to know about Shotgun Wedding?
It was fun. It was a lot of fun. And we really became a family during the filming of this movie. We all lived together and worked together, ate together, and it was a really beautiful experience.
And what's the vibe of your character without giving anything away?
It's a little shady. It's a little shady.
We'll have so much fun tonight. Congratulations. This is pretty epic.
Thank you. All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, so thank you so much, Lenny, for being here. Lenny Kravitz is in the house. You kind of play the, how would you call Sean? He's a bad guy or not? Or you?
He's a little shady. Okay. He's not exactly what he's trying to appear to be.
And he kind of shows a duality. I still don't know if I like him or not. How did you build that around the character?
You're not sure if you like him.
I'm not sure. Do you? Would you be friends with Sean?
Nah. Nah.
Oh, my God. I love it. I feel like he has this, like, toxic, optimistical way of being.
You know, he's trying to get through his situation, but he's not handling it in the right way at all. I don't think he's trying to hurt anybody, but doesn't end up working out that way.
Oh my God. He does what he can. And you know, I just had Josh here and I gave him his chance to stand for Tom. So this is your chance to stand for Sean. Why is he better if you actually think that?
Why is Sean better?
Yes.
He's not better. He's not better.
Oh my God. This is why you're the best, Lenny. You're so honest.
Absolutely.
So Lenny, you've been obviously doing music for a long time and also acting. Do you feel like maybe doing all those music videos help you out to kind of be the actor you are today?
I actually started out in theater in New York City when I was a kid. And it looked like I might have gone in that direction, but music is really my passion. And so I put blinders on and I just went straight for music. But I enjoy doing this in between tours and in between albums when I can.
And you're great at it, so I have to ask you, is there such thing as like a dream role for you?
I don't know. Actually, there's a film that I'm working on right now that I feel is very exciting that's going to be with an album that I'm making, so I can't say too much about it, but I think this is going to be very exciting.
I hate it when it happens. I want to hear everything about it.
But I can't tell you. We're in the very beginning, but the music is recorded.
Thank you so much. And is there anything you want to tell our Latin audiences who are also watching right now? That's why I'm here, from Mexico. So we have a lot of Latinos watching you right now as well, who look up to you.
Well, you know, I started my last world tour in South America, and we're going to do the same later this year. It's one of my favorite places, and we will be back very soon on tour.
Should we expect you in Mexico?
Absolutely.
Okay. I'll be there.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much. Have a great time on your same.
Pleasure.
Have a great night. Yeah. Thanks. Thank you. Hi. How are you feeling? Jennifer Coolidge is in the house, you guys. It's pretty incredible.
I'm so happy to be here. Look, everyone. Hi.
Tell us a little bit about filming this movie. What was the best moment for you?
The greatest moment was having Lenny Kravitz like just across, like I could, he was just like 40 feet from my room, his room. So it was
and?
Really nice to look out at him. He wasn't looking at me, but I was looking at him.
I'm sure that's not true. We're all looking at you tonight. Okay, I have an epic question for you. It's a kind of a tough one. You can basically do no wrong. What would you say is the key to comedy?
The key to comedy? Don't try too hard. Every time I try, it's not very good. Don't try too hard, and don't take yourself seriously, and eat whatever you want.
And what do you want to say to fans at home at the world premiere of Shotgun Wedding?
Please come and watch the movie. Hooray!
All right, well, have a great time. Okay. The world awaits you. Woo!
I will not deny how excited I am because Jennifer Coolidge is in the house. How are you, Jen?
Hi, I'm great.
Oh my God.
Turnout, my God.
Can you see how much people is here to see you because you are so loved?
Well, I think Jennifer Lopez and Josh Duhamel
They are as well, but you are you.
Well, thank you. Well, but anyway, I'll take it. Well, I'll take whatever I can get.
Just trust me, I know what I'm saying. So, I want you to tell us a little bit about Carol, not only as a person, but also as a mother-in-law. This character is quite unique, isn't she?
Yeah, she's a very nice lady, until you mess with her. But, she's very nice. She's been, had a marriage that's worked out very well, and then she comes to go to this wedding that she thinks is going to be, very low-key thing, and then it ends up being very dramatic, wedding interruption. But go ahead.
No, but you actually got to shoot guns and do was there anything you did for the first time on this film?
Yeah, no one's ever trusted me with guns before.
Why? Why is that?
This is my year with guns. White Lotus, they gave me some guns, and this is. What a gift to, for the probably the only time in my life I'll be able to shoot a semi-automatic gun and it was a real gun.
Oh my God, that's scary.
Yeah.
Well, Jennifer, I just told you this and I'm gonna say it on camera because it's true. I love you. I think you're the best. And I have to tell you, I think on behalf of all the fans, that you have made us laugh for so long that, we appreciate it. And I want to know, what's the most appealing thing about comedy? What makes you keep going?
Well, I was sort of giving up, actually. And then things turned around. But, yeah, I mean, I hope I'm an inspiration to people because, it wasn't looking great. And now it's gotten better. Wow. And I'm thrilled. I'm thrilled for this is my, second chapter, I hope.
just hope you never stop making films and shows, and because we really want to watch them.
Oh, hey, thanks a lot. Thank you for saying that. You're the nicest.
Oh, no, I definitely mean this. I definitely mean this. And, you know, there's a lot of people, like you said, who is inspired by you. So what would be your message for all of those people who might be wanting to give up and who just look at you and know that there's a chance?
Well, I said this at an award show the other night, and I really mean, I just, it's not over till you're dead. That's what I said, and I really believe that. I think don't give up. Don't give up. Don't give up on your dreams. Don't give up, because you never know.
You'll never know, I know. And before letting you go, I have to ask you this, because, you know, in this film, you actually tell Jennifer Lopez everything, like we all think that, but you got that chance. How did that feel?
It felt really good, because she really does look like that, you know, and it's sort of, it's kind of unbelievable that someone is just like, got that going on that well. I mean, it's just, you can't help but comment, because it's, she really looks like that. You know,
I just thought when she stepped here, I was like, oh yeah, you're that perfect, that like up close. How come? Come on.
Oh, well, she says she works out, and then I think it's genetics and
it's a miracle, maybe. I don't know.
I think so. I think, yeah. But I'm a fan. I'm a huge fan of hers, and she works her butt off. So she deserves that incredibly hot physique and her beautiful good looks. You know, that's for sure. Yeah.
So do you. So Jennifer, thank you so much for stopping by and enjoy your night.
Thank you.
It was nice to meet you. Bye.
So much has happened already tonight. We've talked to J-Lo, Jennifer Coolidge, Lenny Kravitz. What do you guys think? Let us know in the comments, hashtag shotgun wedding premiere. And it's pretty incredible. I mean, there's an entire photo op happening. Jason Voorhees is over there getting his photo taken in front of a helicopter. Let's go check it out.
Good energy. Keep it up.
Look at you.
The show, it's pretty spectacular. I cannot believe how much has happened already tonight.
Oh my god, this was a crazy moment. I just had a blast interviewing all the actors, all the talent, the filmmakers. Oh god, it's freezing, but we're having
it is very cool.
We're having tons of fun.
Not gonna lie, I had a moment talking to Lenny Kravitz. It was like, oh, okay.
I did too, cool. with Jennifer Lopez. She hugged me and I was like, oh my god, she's hugging me.
That's,
I don't know
so
what to
cool.
do. That was amazing.
So be sure to check out Shotgun Wedding January 27th on Prime Video. And closing us out, we have Edwin McCain singing I'll Be
Bye, guys. Thank you so much for joining us.
Adios.
You ready?
Oh, okay.
The strands in your eyes, the color them wonderful, stab me, steal my breath. And emeralds from mountains thrust towards the sky, never revealing their depth. And tell me that we belong together, dress it up. The trappings of love, I'll be captivated. I'll hang from your lips to stare on the gallows of heartache that hang from above. And I'll be better when I'm older. And I'll be the greatest fan of your life. And rain falls angry on the tin roof as we lie awake in my bed. You're my survival, you're my living proof. My love is alive, not dead. And tell me that we belong together. Dress it up with the trappings of love. I'll be captivated, I'll hang from your lips. Stared on the gallows of heartache that hang from above. And I'll be your crying shoulder. I'll be love's suicide. And I'll be better when I'm old.
We asked our chief taste tester to try our new Bodyarmor light flavors. New flavor number one. New flavor number two. Number two for the win.
to the world premiere of Shotgun Wedding. Are you ready?
Estoy lista. Uno, dos, tres. Hola a todos, my name is Gabby Cam, and in case you hear a funny accent here, that's because I flew all the way from Mexico City to be at this premiere, and how's that for an arrival?
And I'm Mac Wall. I don't know if you just saw, but we just arrived on Zipline to the world premiere of Shotgun Wedding. You look so calm, cool, and collected. How are you doing that?
I'm not. I'm actually faking it pretty nicely, I think, right?
Yeah.
But I'm excited.
Well.
I am really excited about this premiere. I mean, who doesn't love a wedding? It's supposed to be one of the most memorable days of your life, but I think for Jennifer Lopez and Josh Duhamel, it's going to be memorable for all the wrong reasons, I think.
And we're here on Hollywood Boulevard. We've shut the street down for the last 3 days. We have a helicopter, we have a boat, we have a zip line that you just saw us come in on. And in a matter of minutes, we're going to be joined by the cast and crew, including director Jason Moore, Steve Coulter, Desmond Borges, Selena Tan, Callie Hernandez, Cheech Marin, Darcy Carden.
And listen to this, Lenny Kravitz, Jennifer Coolidge, Josh Duhamel, and of course the one and only Jennifer Lopez. This is going to be full of surprises, and we are going to make sure you don't miss a thing. We have people in every single corner of this red carpet, so you don't miss anything.
We are covered all over the carpet tonight. We have an action cam, which will be the zip line, limo cam, fan cam, fashion cam, chopper cam, and even our very own boat cam.
This is the world premiere of Shotgun Wedding. Bienvenidos a la premiere mundial de bodas de plomo. I am Gabby Cam.
And I'm Mac Wall. Get ready for a night to remember as we meet the cast and filmmakers of Shotgun Wedding right here on the green carpet. Let's go check it out. And we're here with Callie Hernandez. Callie, tell us about what you've seen at this premiere so far. Are you so excited to be here?
I literally just got here and got out of the car. So I see a boat, I see you, and I see all you guys.
What are you so excited for audiences to see at the world premiere of Shotgun Wedding tonight?
So many things. Romance, comedy, action, Jennifer Lopez, Jennifer Coolidge, Josh Duhamel, Darcy Carden, Steve Coulter, Selena Tan. I mean, the cast is incredible.
What was it like on set working with this incredible cast?
I mean, like, kind of surreal, you know? I don't really know how I got here, but I'm so happy to be here and truly feels like a family, and it's great. I feel good.
Where did you film, and what was it like being on this in this incredible place, but also you're stuck in a pool for a lot of the film?
Yeah, I mean, we are fully clothed in a pool for most of the film, I would say, at least most of us. We filmed in the Dominican Republic, and it was beautiful and an interesting time to be filming. It was right when COVID was still happening, but it was like right when things were starting to kick off again, and It was lovely and interesting, yeah.
Fabulous. And can you say hi to all of our fans from around the world?
Yes, I can. Hi, fans from around the world. Enjoy.
And so there's literally, people are watching from around the world right now. What are you most excited? What is this film all about? And how would you like describe it to your mom or your best friend?
How did I describe it to my mom and my best friend? It's a comedy. I mean, it's a rom-com, and I think it's about love, and I think it's about family, and hopefully it's just fun.
Fabulous. Well, thank you so much. Enjoy your time tonight.
Thanks so much. Nice to see you.
Can you put that closer? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
And you're actually married to Jennifer Coolidge in this film.
At the drop, the stars are starting to arrive. There are hundreds of fans on the green carpet, and I'm about to be joined by director Jason Moore. Oh, no, that was a fake out.
I love how your character is always recording. If we actually got to see what he recorded throughout this film.
Oh, yeah. I had my own clapper. I started feeling like I was a part of the crew. And at one point, they were supposed to shoot something from his point of view, and the cinematographer said, no, Steve, that's my job. And I was like, okay. Yeah, I shot everything.
Oh, you should try your own film.
Yes, actually, I could be like a director's or a Larry's cut.
Oh, my God, what would it be like? I feel like...
I got everything. So.
I also have to tell you, because if I would have to choose between the mother and father-in-law, for me, my favorite ones would be you and Jennifer. Why would that be? Do you think your guys are better than...
Because we're from Michigan, and we're just normal, and we have no drama. Well, no, that's not true. We have a lot.
And there's drama everywhere. Come on.
We made a movie, actually. That's, yes. Oh, yeah.
I love it. So, well, I want you to know that there's a lot of people from all over the world watching right now. We have people from Mexico, which is my country.
Okay, yo hablo un poquito de español, pero dice que bienvenido México y gracias por viendo esto.
Steve, I was not expecting this at all.
I lived in Colombia for 4 years, so estoy recordando unas palabras y olvidando muchas más.
You just made my day. Thank you so much.
Okay, pues, de nada.
Buena suerte, diviértete mucho.
Gracias.
Thank you so much and have a great time. Bye.
Hey, it's Mac here at the Limo Drop, and we are here with director Jason Moore. Jason, tell us how excited you are to be here tonight. It's
so
spectacular.
Excited. It's huge. Look at all these people. Hey, guys. So glad to have everybody here and get the cast together again. I'm absolutely thrilled.
Tell us about this cast and what made you say, I have to make Shotgun Wedding.
Shotgun Wedding, when I read the first script, it was just like fun and funny, and it was kind of like an adventure romance that we haven't seen in a long time. And it is, it's an opportunity to get all this kind of crazy cast together, and we got an amazing group of people.
Tell us about your time on set. What was the vibe like?
You know, we were shooting during COVID, and it was like, you know, what's this going to be like away from loved ones? But we were in this gorgeous location, and the cast, the wedding party, all really bonded. They like lived together, had pool parties, dance parties, watched each other's movies, and did like inside the actor's studio interviews. They really bonded in it, and it was fun for us, and then also made it onto the screen, which is great.
How do you do that combination of heart, comedy, action, all packed into one? It's a delicate balance.
It is a delicate balance. You find the actors who know how to negotiate all those places, and then you kind of just play and turn the dials. But that was part of the fun challenge of the movie, was kind of making it feel fire on all those cylinders.
And a kind of tough question. What would you say is the key to comedy?
Surprise. And silence sometimes.
Timing.
Timing. Yeah.
Well, have a great time tonight. I can't wait for everybody to see it. Great. Thanks.
Callie Hernandez is in the house. How are you?
I'm good.
You're good. You look amazing.
Thank you. So do you.
Oh, thank you. We're kind of cold, but we're not going to say that on camera. Oh, I just did.
Oh, we just did. Oh, whoopsies. But I didn't do the zip line, and you did.
I did, and that was a crazy idea. But Callie, please talk to me about your character. I know you're the sister of the bride. How was it like to be J-Lo's sister? That looks like a crazy thing to be.
It's pretty crazy. I mean, yeah, I play, J-Lo plays Darcy in the film, and I play her kind of a cut and dry younger sister, maybe a little bit of a screw up in the film. Okay. My character's name is Jamie.
I know. It's crazy. And I know you got to spend a lot of time in the water for this film. Can you tell me about that? Was it as bad as it might sound as I'm saying it?
We did spend a lot of time in a pool, fully clothed. However, I mean, we shot in the Dominican Republic, and we were in an infinity pool overlooking, it was whale season, there were whales jumping out of the water. I mean, I'm not complaining.
Yeah, I wish I would have been there.
Yeah, and I'm surrounded by, you know, some of the best people I've ever gotten to work with, so we had a blast.
I can only imagine. And, you know, I really have to ask you, how good of a bridesmaid will you be?
Okay, I just kind of did it. I think I'm pretty good.
She's over there.
Okay. Oh, yeah, yeah. She's over there.
I think I'm pretty good. I like having a job at a wedding, okay, and not having to
just be there.
Do anything else? Dancing and jobs at the wedding is good.
Well, a job can be just like have fun, I guess. Yeah. I mean, what is that one thing that you love about weddings?
Love.
I love.
Love and, I don't know, I like that everybody kind of just cuts loose and can celebrate at the end of the night. I feel like there's rare occasions for that now.
Right, yeah, you're right. Are you a dancer at all?
I have done it before. I wouldn't say I'm a dancer, but I like to boogie.
But you have a good time.
Yeah, sure.
All right. Callie, thank you so much for stopping by, and I hope you enjoy your night.
Thank you. How was the zip line?
It was good. You should try it.
Should I?
You should try it. I'll clap from here. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's not that high. Okay. Guys, so I just learned that I can actually use my Spanish to pronounce Alberto Isaac's name. How does that sound?
It sounds terrific. So refreshing to hear my name said that way.
I can say it many times. Alberto Isaac, Alberto Isaac.
Yeah, that's me.
So tell us a little bit about Ace. I mean, he is such an important part of this resort. Yes. Tell us a little bit what attracted you.
Well, my wife and I own this resort hotel in the Philippines, and my wife is a take charge woman, and I pretty much just go along and do what she says to do, and then we get invaded by pirates. Yeah.
Oh my God, that's crazy.
Right? Yeah. So we deal with it.
Yeah, there's nothing left to do. So how do you think you would do if you would have to deal with that in real life? Do you think you would stay cool or just no?
Oh, my gosh. Fortunately, my wife is Emily Kuroda, okay, a famous actress, is also a very aggressive woman. Okay. And I would say, what would you do, Emily?
We're going to do what you say, Emily.
Yeah.
Okay, right. So, you know, Alberto, there's a lot of Latin people watching us right now. That's why I flew all the way from Mexico to be here. So do you want to say something to the fans who are going to enjoy this adventure pretty soon in Amazon Prime Video?
Oh, you are going to enjoy it so much. Tanto, tanto.
Oh, mucho. Oh, no. Tanto, it's also Spanish.
Oh, really?
Yeah, okay. It means a lot. Yeah.
All right. Well, you will.
Okay, so thank you so much for your time, Alberto, and enjoy your time here.
Thank you.
I'm here with Steve Coulter, who plays Larry. Can you tell us about your character, Larry?
I am the father of the groom, and I have the privilege of being married to Jennifer Coolidge in the movie, which is a hard job for anybody. It was wonderful. It's just like a ridiculous dream come true that you didn't know you had. So, yes.
And what surprises are you excited to share with audiences tonight?
I can't tell the surprises. There are pirates, and you can't lose with pirates. So there you go.
You heard it here first. You can't lose with pirates.
That's my new catchphrase. That's it. Yes.
Well, enjoy. Have a great time tonight. Thank you so much. I'll see you in a bit.
Bye, guys. Bye.
Desmond Borges, it's in the house. Ricky Silver, the best man. Desmond, you were just telling me you have Latin heritage.
I do. My father was born right outside of Ponce in Puerto Rico, and then my mother's family is Italian and Greek.
Oh my God, that's a great mix.
Yeah, a lot of good food.
Like, what's your favorite Hispanic item? I would say Latino food.
Oh man, well, arroz con gandules.
Oh my God.
Yeah, traditional salt pork at the bottom, pork loin, sofrito, sazon, you know.
You're just making me hungry right now.
Do they have any here?
I don't think so.
We'll have to make a call.
I know. Desmond, congratulations on this film. Can you tell us a little bit about what was your favorite part of working with these people, which is amazing?
Oh man, you know, I think the entire experience was probably my favorite part. I mean, if you imagine it was in early 2021 where everyone was still huddled up at their homes with their loved ones in a pandemic, and then all of a sudden we were invited to come to the beautiful island of the Dominican Republic to all hang out together, eat together, and shoot a lovely film together. So I mean, I don't think you can ask for something that was, you know, more beautiful and needed in that time of mass anxiety.
I mean, I'm curious whether or not you actually had to laugh at certain takes, because I don't know how can you stand like still when you have all of this going on around you.
Yeah, I mean, especially when you have Jennifer Coolidge and Steve Coulter together and just kind of going off the page and just delivering some beautiful, beautiful, really funny stuff. It's really difficult to keep it together.
And then we have Ricky.
Yeah, Ricky Silver.
Do you think he's an actually good best man?
I think he does the best job that he can, you know?
Does he?
He does. You know, Ricky's still stuck in this phase that he thinks he has to wear this mask of always saying the wrong thing at the wrong time to make people laugh. But really what he wants to do is open up a drawer at home, let the universe know he's ready to find the love of his life, invite her in, and watch Netflix and have a pint of ice cream.
Do you feel like weddings are a good place to find love? I'm not sure. I feel like everything is just stuck in the moment.
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, I personally didn't find love at a wedding. I found love somewhere else. But, you know, I feel like I know people who have found love at weddings, or at least found a good time.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what is that one thing that cannot be missing at a wedding? Obviously the bride and the groom, but what else?
Right. Well, I guess it would have to be a tie between great music and great food, right?
Yeah,
they kind of go together.
Have you ever been to a Mexican wedding? Oh. We are crazy people.
No, tell me all about it.
Oh my God. We even have like this choreographed dances and stuff like that. And they just give away props at the wedding. It's crazy.
And then people dance with the props?
Yeah. They wear hats and like this.
I love that.
We're going to have to invite you to a Mexican wedding.
Sounds good.
Desmond, have a great time at your premiere. And thank you so much for stopping by.
Appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Have a great time. Thank you.
Okay, so as we mentioned, there are people watching from all over the globe, and we want to hear from you guys. Tell us what you're excited to see at hashtag ShotgunWeddingPremiere, and let us know what questions you have for the cast and filmmakers. Oh, I see Gabby is over there with Desmond, or is it Jason Moore, director Jason Moore? Let's check it out.
Para todo el público latino que nos está viendo en este momento, Jason Moore, el director de la película, está con nosotros. Jason Moore, the director of the film, is about to talk with us. Jason, I don't know where to start. What was the one thing that worried you the most when you heard you were gonna do like an action rom-com film?
There's actually all these scenes where all the actors are in a pool, they're being held kidnapped, and I thought, oh no, this is gonna be really hard. Wet actors in and out. Turns out it was like being at a beach pool. They all stayed in the pool all day, had a great time. So the thing I was most worried about didn't come true.
Oh, that's great. That's a great scene.
Yeah, it was really good. Thanks.
And you know, you actually managed to put together an amazing cast. How was it like to work with them?
They are an incredible group of artists from all kind of different places, and they all bring such joy, and they bring their game. They love each other. They actually a lot of them live together and had a really good time bonding, which was great. Shooting a movie that's supposed to be about family and fun, they made it a lot of fun. I can't say enough about them.
I will actually ask you, did you find out anything you didn't know about them while working with them, maybe something unexpected?
Well, I had never met any of them. So
what?
So there's always just getting to know what somebody's like. I had Zooms with a lot of people, you know, but there's a lot of kindness and grounded authenticity in this group. There's some, you know, big personalities and everything, but there's a lot of kindness and a lot of heart, which also makes a better movie.
Can I say I feel that from you right now? I can tell you're kind and have a big heart.
Try.
Yeah, you do. And you know, I'm obviously Latina, I'm from Mexico. So I think I need to ask you, how would you describe the Jennifer Lopez effect? Because I think it's massive, isn't it?
It's planetary. I mean, it's like it's like gravity and out of this world and shining star. And also, though, extremely authentic and grounded and also kind. She wants everyone to succeed. It's kind of magical, and it's an honor.
Such an honor to get to see her on screen and you directing this. Thank you so much for the film, and I hope you enjoy your night.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
Have a great time. Thank you.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
Amigos, la dueña del resort está con nosotros, Selena Tan. Selena, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. I'm loving this vibe. It's really fun.
It's really relaxed, isn't it? Like, it doesn't really feel stiff. Everything is so chill.
Exactly. I feel like I'm a beachfront resort, filming the movie all over again.
Can you imagine what would it be like to actually have a resort? Come on.
Well, I had to imagine. Because in the movie, of course, I have a resort that they all come to, and then things go terribly wrong, but we rescue it in the end.
Oh, my God. And Alberto just stopped by, and he said he was always chill because he had you in charge.
I was always chill because I had Alberto next to me.
I'm scared. Like, I'm glad I wasn't there because apparently no one was in charge, or everyone was in charge.
Clearly, no one was in charge. No. I think in the end, both Jennifer and Josh were in charge because they really brought this movie right through to the happy, happy end.
Yes, of course. And for everyone who's watching us right now from all over the world, how would you describe the film? Like, if someone turns on the film, what will they find?
Definitely a rom-com, a lot of love, but very spunky as well. And there's a lot of action. So if you like action, I mean, really, there's a lot of action. So it's a film for the whole family. It's great.
And a lot of one-liners as well.
A very good one-liners.
I just want to say, like, I want to go back to Mexico and just say those in English. No one will understand it, but...
Oh, but I'm sure you'll make an impact.
I'll try to translate it. Selena, thank you so much for stopping by, and I hope you enjoy your premiere.
I will. Thank you so much for having me.
Have a great time.
See you.
See you soon.
Okay, so we're here with some Shotgun Wedding fans. Tell us your names. Oh. Okay, tell us your name and where you're from.
I'm Natalie. I'm from Chicago.
How's it going? So from West Hollywood.
Nice, right around the corner. And who are you most excited to see tonight?
Jennifer Lopez.
Jennifer Lopez, all the way.
And Jennifer Coolidge, and Lenny Kravitz, and Josh. Everyone. And the cast is incredible, so.
And do you know anything about this movie? Have you had any, you know, wedding horror stories?
My end, but I know it's filmed in the DR, which is so exciting to see.
Yeah, I've just seen the trailer, so I'm excited to see all the action, the explosions, you know, a little bit of the romance, so it should be a good time.
Fabulous. And what's the worst thing that you could possibly imagine happening at a wedding?
Oh my God, just explosion, ooh, failure, who knows?
Wow. I know, I'm thinking like maybe getting stood up, like that would probably be the worst thing, right? Your partner not showing up.
Has that ever happened to you? Anything that would be surprising?
I'd rather not say.
Just stood up on a date, but that's it.
Be sure to check out Shotgun Wedding Premiere, #Shotgun Wedding. Yeah. Oh my God, look, there's Sarah. She looks incredible. I love that dress. So beautiful. Look how cute everybody is. They're matching suits. I love it.
Resort. Tell us a little bit what attracted you.
Well, my wife and I own this.
She looks spectacular. It's beyond. I don't even know how that dress is really staying on. She looks amazing. I told her that earlier. It's beyond. On the red carpet, getting his photo taken by all the paparazzi. We've got our fans in the back. It's pretty exciting. I love being here. There's so much action happening all around me. We've got all these influencers going down this zip line right now. We've got all these fans. We've got a boat over there. We are on Hollywood Boulevard. We've completely taken over, you know, like five streets of Hollywood Boulevard here in Los Angeles, California. And it's really just so cool to experience it because this is such a fun movie. You're going to have this wild ride. There's so much heart and romance, and it's about this wonderful couple and then pirates attack. And it's totally unexpected. You never know what's coming next. And it's just really a fun ride that I cannot wait for all of you to experience and see what is in store for us tonight. And then on the 27th, when we see Shotgun Wedding on Amazon Prime Video. Okay, and I've just been told that we are about to get Lenny Kravitz, which is beyond exciting. I know the fans behind us are so excited to see Lenny Kravitz. Apparently, he has flown in on his private jet. And I mean, I would have loved to have been on that jet with him. It didn't happen, but we'll maybe get him next time. It'll be really fun. Oh my gosh, we have influencers on the red carpet in spectacular outfits. Look at that gorgeous purple one. It's just such an amazing time. I love being out, you know, we're getting back out into the world and everyone's having fun and celebrating such a fabulous movie that's, you know, it's just in time for Valentine's Day. It's definitely one that I'll go to the theaters to see. Okay, so we were just talking about the people that we're most excited to see, and over here we heard Lenny Kravitz. Tell us why.
Oh my God, he's a rock star. Are you kidding? Legend. I cannot wait to see him.
You were telling me about what you think he's going to be wearing. What do you think?
I'm hoping leather. It's going to be totally like rocker chic. Leather, sunglasses. He's got to bring it. So I'm so excited to see him.
Who are you most excited to see?
Jennifer Lopez, of course, you know.
What do you think she's going to be wearing?
You know, green Versace dress. No, I'm kidding. Right.
That would be amazing. And what do you think Jennifer Coolidge is going to have on tonight?
Oh, she's going to have like a beautiful gown, stunning from head to toe.
Jennifer is so exciting. Can you guys name maybe some of your favorite lines of Jennifer Coolidge? Do you have any in mind? Let's think about it. Who's got one? What do you got? Hold on. Here we go. We got one. It's the 4th of July. And I want a hot dog real bad. I knew exactly which one you were going for. What about Cinderella story? Does anybody know, what does she say? She says, the cucumbers in your eyes, they say, you don't look mad. And she says, oh, it's the Botox. I can't show emotion for another 3 hours. That's my favorite. What about Jennifer Lopez? What's a favorite film role of yours of Jennifer Lopez?
Oh my God, Wedding Planner is my favorite.
What is it about that movie that you love so much?
Everything, her childhood story from the beginning, how she just loved love, and then she grew up falling in love and just getting married herself in a small wedding.
I would say Jennifer Lopez is the queen of romance movies. They're just so perfect for this time of year. It's like, we're, you know, it's cold out. We want to cuddle up and watch a Valentine's Day.
Yes, it's perfect timing for Valentine's Day and love.
What do you think is your favorite Valentine's Day movie?
Oh my God, I love Jennifer Lopez rom-com, so yeah, Made in Manhattan, Marry Me, anything that she's been in, yeah, for sure.
And what's your name? Who else are you excited to see tonight?
You know, the whole cast is like so much fun, yeah. My name's Nick, by the way. Yeah, yeah. Thank you.
Where are you from, Nick?
Ontario, so not too far.
Not too far. How did you hear about this premiere? How did you all get here?
You know, I actually heard it through him, so.
Oh, tell me, how did you hear about it?
So I'm here for J-Lo personally. I'm the biggest J-lover here. I don't care what anyone says. Yeah, I almost pulled up in the green dress. Almost. But I don't want to match, you know. But yeah, so like I heard of it on Twitters and I signed up and I got on the guest list and here we are now.
And who's we? Who are you? Tell us about how you got here and why you're excited to be here.
I actually had a lie to my boss for J-Lo, but I could always get a new job. I can't always come to a J-Lo premiere. And I came with my best friend. We had to harass people for tickets, and now we're here.
What happens if your boss sees this live stream?
Well, then I'm with J-Lo and you're at work, so have fun.
You're supposed to be at work right now?
Yeah.
What do you do?
I'm a supervisor at, yeah, I don't want to say I hate it.
I literally am getting her fired in this moment, and I feel terrible about it. She's like not even telling me. I am a supervisor. I do all the things, of course. I'm really sorry to your boss.
I'm not at all.
How long have you been at this job? You're with J-Lo, and it doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter. 5 years.
Oh, wow. Okay. Giving up a lot to be here with us. It's very exciting.
It's priorities.
And what are some of your favorite J-Lo roles?
Made in Manhattan, definitely. Her entire role in the Get Right music video.
Okay, I've just heard that we have Josh Duhamel coming towards us. Hopefully we can get him. He might head straight over to the boat. We'll see what happens. Okay, I'm watching. Let's see if we can get him.
Thank you.
Who you are and why you're excited to be here.
Gibson here, looking sharp. Look at this. Look at this, man.
It's the Shotgun Wedding premiere. Anything can happen. Tell us why you're here and why you're excited.
Lenny Kravitz stand-in. You know, in the movie world, we call it second team. But no, all jokes aside, me and Josh, as y'all know, we got a bit of a history.
Oh, yeah.
We've done a couple things. You know, we the first one's on the other side of $1 billion for Paramount.
Is that
with
true?
It's true. Shia told me. But yeah. I'm here because I'm so proud of my brother, your movie, man. I love Jennifer, and Lenny is like my favorite human on earth. So I was just so crazy. I was just talking to Mike about you, man.
You were?
And Josh, tell us to the fans, what is this movie all about, and why should everyone be excited?
I'm sorry. What was the question?
How would you describe this movie to fans at home?
It is. It's a big, fun, almost throwback sort of action comedy, romantic sort of big popcorn movie. That's the best way I can describe it.
And what do you think is the biggest surprise that fans will see tonight at the world premiere?
I don't want to give.
Josh is still handsome.
No.
I mean, it's true. It's very true.
I'm sure shoot this guy at any angle. Look at him.
It's
ridiculous.
You ever seen Lenny Kravitz cut into a million pieces?
Okay, I'm so excited.
I would do it. I'm seeing it happens in the movie.
Oh, right.
You asked for a surprise. I gave you one.
Spoiler alert, I guess. All right, well, head in, guys, and have the best time. I think you're going to head over there to the boat camera.
I'm on my way.
So, guys, I'm really excited to introduce Darcy Carden in the house. Harriet, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm really excited to talk to you. And, you know, this is your night. Like, after all the work, after all these months or years or whatever it took shooting this, now you're finally here and you're going to introduce it to people. Yeah. How do you feel?
I'm so excited. It has been a while. It's been almost 2 years, and we've been excited to show the world what we did in the Dominican Republic. And you said, like, all this work. And for me, it was just, like, the most fun vacation with a bunch of cool people. And on the side, we did some work. So what you'll see tonight is the work that we got to do.
I mean, if you would have invited me, I would have gone happily not to work, too.
I know. I just met you tonight, though, man.
Right. That's good.
Yeah.
But, you know, I love this film, and I love your character is in such a peculiar state of mind. How would you describe Harriet?
How would I describe Harriet? She is, you know, she's like in her own little world, and she wants to kind of make, you know, everybody feel very like at peace and zen, but it kind of tends to do the opposite. You know, she's like tries to be a calming presence, and it makes everybody really irritated. She's not very well liked.
And is she like the perfect guest for a wedding? Is she?
No. But yeah, no, she thinks she is, but she is not the perfect wedding guest. Yeah.
Darcy, can you tell me what was your favorite part of shooting this film?
I mean, the cast, as you know, is like it's just the most amazing group of people. We came from all over the world into this beautiful location where we all lived together and got to shoot this amazing movie. And it was like, we fell in love with each other. It was like a real family. We had the best time. The cast, I am so excited to see everybody tonight. We've been sort of seeing each other today and last week at the hotel, and I want more.
Oh my God, you're going to have a blast tonight. And before letting you go, I have to ask, if you were to describe expectations versus reality shooting this film, what was it like? Like, was it anything like you expected at all?
It was better. Because everybody got along so well. I knew the place was going to be beautiful. I knew J-Lo was going to be amazing. I knew Jason Moore was going to be a great director. But everybody just got along so well. It really was like, I feel almost bad. It was so fun. I know it was work, but it was just so damn fun.
You can tell you had fun. That's why the film is funny as well, right?
Yeah, it is fun. It's totally fun. You can like feel it. Yeah, for sure. You can tell.
And, you know, just so you know, there's a lot of people watching us right now from all over the world. I'm actually from Mexico, so okay. Is there anything you want to say to the Latin audiences who are also going to watch this film?
Oh, I hope you just have the time of your life watching it. We had so much fun making it. I'm glad you're watching it wherever you are. Enjoy. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Woo. Enjoy your night, please.
I'm excited for them to see the whole world and everybody's playing.
Jennifer!
Hi, Jennifer! So exciting. Tell us what fans should be excited to see tonight. This is so amazing just to be here.
I'm excited to see it with an audience tonight. You know, when you see a comedy, it's always better to see it in the theater because you get everybody laughing and everything. So I'm really excited about it.
And what's unique about this action comedy that also has a lot of heart?
Yeah, it's funny. You know, I've done a lot of romantic comedies, but I've never done an action comedy. So it was actually a lot of fun. I don't know if you guys remember who Lucille Ball was, but I felt like I was getting my Lucille. You know what I mean? So it was, yeah, it was amazing.
What was the hardest moment, speaking of that?
The whole thing, it was amazing.
Hardest moment you had to shoot?
The hardest moment? Probably the zip line, you know, when Josh had to kind of, we had to fall off of it, and then he was like upside down, and there was a lot of moments, though. The car.
And you were tied together for a lot of the film.
The whole film. The whole film, we were handcuffed together, so. Yeah, it was crazy. It was fun, though.
Can you say hi to all of our fans at home and from around the world?
Hello, everybody. I love you guys. I love you. Thank you.
Love you.
Thank you so much. This is amazing. Have so much fun tonight. Oh, sure.
En este momento porque ya llegó el hombre del momento, the guy of the hour, Josh Duhamel. How are you?
I'm doing fantastic. This is unbelievable.
Do you ever get used to this, like, at all?
I haven't done anything like this for years. Amazon Prime Video did this huge.
Oh my God.
They really did.
Did you see that there's a zip line over there?
No, there's a zip line
there
here?
There is a zip line in your red carpet, right?
Yeah. We can all do that?
Yeah. I just did.
I'm going to do that.
Oh my God. So,
awesome. We're going to do the zip line.
Oh, my God. Yes, please. Please do. Dresses fly pretty nicely there. I doubt that. I did it.
Did you really?
I did. There's a video of me. But, Josh, congratulations on the film. Please tell me a little bit about this Tom guy who's pretty much a groomzilla.
He is definitely a groomzilla. That is the truth. He is somebody who is very excited about making sure that everything goes perfectly at this wedding. And you'll see very quickly it does not. So, you know, I think that's part of the fun of the movie is when have you ever seen a dude who handles all the details of a wedding?
I know, and he does everything, like everything is handmade. I love that.
Just like this boat, I made these right here.
Oh my God.
I made those. I was here earlier today.
I can only imagine. You have pretty beautiful handwriting.
Thank you.
So tell me a little bit about the boat, because you just told me that you have that back home. What?
So I have a lake in Minnesota that I spend a lot of time at, and this boat was something that was at the movie, and I asked them what they paid for it and would they give me a deal on it. And we ended up working it out. I have the actual boat from the movie at my lake in Minnesota.
Oh, my God, that's amazing.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, obviously, this is an unusual mix of genres, I guess, with rom-com and action. Did you get to do anything for the first time?
Yeah, I've never hung 25 feet in the air with Lenny Kravitz. That was a first. Or J-Lo. It was just one of those movies that I had. I love Jason Moore. I love this director. He's got a really very specific sensibility about the kind of humor that he likes to put on screen. And it's a big, heightened comedy with a lot of action and a lot of romance. And I think that that's what people are really going to love. It's just a big old popcorn movie.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. And, you know, I think we need to talk about the rivalry with Lenny Kravitz. Like, this is your time to stand for Tom. Why is he better than Sean?
How do you beat Lenny Kravitz?
That's very hard.
Beat Lenny Kravitz.
But if anyone is to beat him, it's you.
It's perfect casting, because if there's anybody that's going to make a man feel insecure on his wedding day, it's Lenny Kravitz.
Okay. Is this a confession right here at all?
Yeah.
Are you insecure?
I'm very insecure on that, man.
Oh, my God. You guys look amazing in the film. Josh, thank you so much for stopping by, and I hope you enjoy your night.
I will. Thank you so much.
Is there anything you want to say to Latin American fans?
I see Cheech down there. Hi, Cheech.
Thank you. Have a great time.
All right, take care. Bye-bye.
Amigos, es momento de saludar a Jennifer López. Y en caso de que se lo estuvieran preguntando, guys, I have to say, yes, she is that perfect up close. Oh, my God. Come on.
Thank you. How are you?
I'm good. Jennifer, there's a lot of Latin people watching us right now.
¿Cómo están? Los quiero mucho.
Congratulations on the film. And, you know, I need to ask you, what appealed to you about this story, not only as an actress, but as a producer as well?
You know, it just, I read it, and it's funny because I had just done a movie that was about a wedding, and it didn't seem like the perfect next thing to do, but I loved the script so much. It was so well written, it was so funny, and I just had never done an action comedy. I've done a lot of romantic comedies, but never a romantic action comedy, so I'm super excited to see it with an audience tonight.
And if there was...
It's a little chilly out here, that's why we're...
I know, yeah, I'm like this, I'm totally stiff. I'm like, yeah, I'm having a blast right now. But you know what? You are kind of like the sun. I have to say.
You are.
Oh my God. No one looks this perfect in this weather but Jennifer López. And you know, I have to tell you this because I'm Latina as well, I'm from Mexico. And on behalf of all the Latin people, you are an inspiration for us. And there are so many people looking up to you that want to be just like you. Is there something you want to tell them in case they're pursuing their dreams?
It's just never give up. You always have to kind of stay focused on the important things in life. You have to not let anybody tell you who you are, not let other people discourage you, and just know the power that you hold inside of yourself. Because we all hold this tremendous power that we don't know until we let it out. And then all of a sudden it's like, oh, everything's going the way I wanted it to. Once you start believing that it is. So it's an exciting thing to be here tonight for me, because this is a dream for me. This is my dream.
Oh my God. And you're living the dream. Do you ever get used to this, to people really?
No, I don't.
No, oh my.
Always like the first time.
Yeah, I can only. Yeah, I can only imagine. And I also have to ask you, how did you build the courage to actually just step up and be who you are? Because I love that about you, how authentic you are.
You know, over time. I think when I was young, I had a lot of ideas, and I was like, okay, I'm going to go for it. I'm going to do all these things. And then little by little, you get a lot of no's along the way, and you have to have a tough skin. You have to go, okay, you said no, and you said no, and you said no, and you said no, but you said yes. And then you're going to keep going. And you have to, again, that's where the belief in yourself is really, really important.
Jennifer, eres una inspiración. Gracias.
Yo también. Thank you so much.
Have a great time at your premiere. Jennifer López, la mejor del mundo.
Yes.
Nice to see you as well. Thanks for being here. This is so cool. I can't tell you. So we're talking to fans from around the world. What is one thing that you want them to know about Shotgun Wedding?
It was fun. It was a lot of fun. And we really became a family during the filming of this movie. We all lived together and worked together, ate together, and it was a really beautiful experience.
And what's the vibe of your character without giving anything away?
It's a little shady. A little shady.
We'll have so much fun tonight. Congratulations. This is pretty epic.
Thank you. All right. Thank you.
Okay, so thank you so much, Lenny, for being here. Lenny Kravitz is in the house. You kind of play the, how would you call Sean? He's a bad guy or not? Or you?
He's a little shady. Okay. He's not exactly what he's trying to appear to be.
Okay. And he kind of shows a duality. I still don't know if I like him or not. How did you build that around the character?
You're not sure if you like him?
I'm not sure. Do you? Would you be friends with Sean?
Nah, nah.
Oh my God, I love it. I feel like he has this like toxic, optimistical way of being.
You know, he's trying to get through his situation, but he's not handling it in the right way at all. I don't think he's trying to hurt anybody, but doesn't end up working out that way.
He does what he can. And you know, I just had Josh here and I gave him his chance to stand for Tom. So this is your chance to stand for Sean. Why is he better if you actually think that?
Why is Sean better?
Yes.
He's not better. He's not better.
Oh, my God. This is why you're the best, Lenny. You're so honest.
Absolutely.
So, Lenny, you've been obviously doing music for a long time and also acting. Do you feel like maybe doing all those music videos help you out to kind of be the actor you are today?
I actually started out in theater in New York City when I was a kid. And it looked like I might have gone in that direction, but music is really my passion. And so I put blinders on and I just
went straight for music. But I enjoy doing this in between tours and in between albums when I can.
And you're great at it, so I have to ask you, is there such thing as like a dream role for you?
I don't know. Actually, there's a film that I'm working on right now that I feel is very exciting, that's going to be with an album that I'm making, so I can't say too much about it, but I think this is going to be very exciting.
I hate it when it happens. I want to hear everything about it.
I can't tell you. We're in the very beginning, but the music is recorded.
Thank you so much. And is there anything you want to tell our Latin audiences who are also watching right now? That's why I'm here, from Mexico. So we have a lot of Latinos watching you right now as well, who look up to you.
Well, you know, I started my last world tour in South America, and we're going to do the same later this year. It's one of my favorite places, and we will be back very soon on tour.
Should we expect you in Mexico?
Absolutely.
Okay. I'll be there.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much. Have a great time on your same.
Pleasure.
Have a great night. Yeah. Thanks. Thank you.
Hi. How are you feeling? Jennifer Coolidge is in the house, you guys. It's pretty incredible.
I'm so happy to be here. Look, everyone. Hi.
Tell us a little bit about filming this movie. What was the best moment for you?
The greatest moment was having Lenny Kravitz, like, just across, like, I could... He was just like 40 feet from my room, his room. So it was
and?
Really nice to look out at him. He wasn't looking at me, but I was looking at him.
I'm sure that's not true. We're all looking at you tonight. Okay, I have an epic question for you. It's a kind of a tough one. You can basically do no wrong. What would you say is the key to comedy?
The key to comedy? Don't try too hard. Every time I try, it's not very good. Don't try too hard, and don't take yourself seriously, and eat whatever you want.
And what do you want to say to fans at home at the world premiere of Shotgun Wedding?
Please come and watch the movie. Hooray!
All right, well, have a great time. Okay. The world awaits you. Woo!
Hold on.
So guys, I will not deny how excited I am because Jennifer Coolidge is in the house. How are you, Jen?
Hi, I'm great.
Oh my God.
Turnout, my God.
Can you see how much people is here to see you because you are so loved?
Well, I think Jennifer Lopez and Josh Duhamel have to...
I mean, they are as well, but you are you.
Well, thank you. Well, but anyway, I'll take it. I'll take it. Well, I'll take whatever I can get.
Just trust me. I know what I'm saying. So, I want you to tell us a little bit about Carol, not only as a person, but also as a mother-in-law. This character is quite unique, isn't she?
Yeah, she's a very nice lady until you mess with her. But, yeah, she's very nice. She's been, you know, had a marriage that's worked out very well, and then she comes to go to this wedding that she thinks is going to be, you know, very low-key thing, and then it ends up being... very dramatic wedding interruption. But go ahead.
No, but you actually got to shoot guns and do like, was there anything you did for the first time on this film?
Yeah, no one's ever trusted me with guns before.
Why? Why is that?
This is my year with guns. You know, White Lotus, they gave me some guns and yes, and then this is what a gift to, you know, for the probably the only time in my life I'll be able to, like, you know, shoot a semi-automatic gun, and it was a real gun, you know.
Oh my God, that's scary.
Yeah.
Well, Jennifer, I just told you this, and I'm going to say it on camera because it's true. I love you. I think you're the best. And I have to tell you, I think, on behalf of all the fans, that you have made us laugh for so long that, you know, we appreciate it. And I want to know, what's the most appealing thing about comedy? What makes you keep going?
Well, I was sort of giving up, actually. And then things turned around. But, yeah, I mean, I hope I'm an inspiration to people because, you know, it wasn't looking great, and now it's gotten better. Wow. And I'm thrilled. I'm thrilled for, you know, this is my, you know, second chapter, I hope.
I just hope you never stop making films and shows, and because we really want to watch them.
Thanks a lot. Thank you for saying that. You're the nicest.
Oh, no, I definitely mean this. I definitely mean this. And, you know, there's a lot of people, like you said, who is inspired by you. So what would be your message for all of those people who might be wanting to give up and who just look at you and know that there's a chance?
Well, I said this at an award show the other night, and I really mean it. It's not over till you're dead. That's what I said, and I really believe that. I think don't give up. Don't give up. Don't give up on your dreams. Don't give up, because you never know.
You'll never know, I know. And before letting you go, I have to ask you this, because, you know, in this film, you actually tell Jennifer Lopez everything, like we all think that, but you got that chance. How did that feel?
It felt really good, because she really does look like that. You know, and it's sort of... it's kind of unbelievable that someone is just like got that going on that well. I mean, it's just, you can't help but comment because it's, she really looks like that, you know?
I just thought when she stepped here, I was like, oh yeah, you're that perfect, that like up close. How come? Come on.
Oh, well, she says she works out, and then I think it's genetics and,
it's a miracle, maybe. I don't know.
I think so. I think. But I'm a fan. I'm a huge fan of hers, and she works her butt off. So she deserves that incredibly hot physique and her beautiful good looks. You know, that's for sure. Yeah.
So do you. So Jennifer, thank you so much for stopping by and enjoy your night.
Thank you.
It was nice to meet you. Bye.
So much has happened already tonight. We've talked to J-Lo, Jennifer Coolidge, Lenny Kravitz. What do you guys think? Let us know in the comments, hashtag shotgun wedding premiere. And it's pretty incredible. I mean, there's an entire photo op happening. Jason Voorhees is over there getting his photo taken in front of a helicopter. Let's go check it out.
Good energy. Awesome. Keep it up.
Look at you. And that's me.
The end of the show. It's pretty spectacular. I cannot believe how much has happened already tonight.
Oh my God, this was a crazy moment. I just had a blast interviewing all the actors, all the talent, the filmmakers. Oh God, it's freezing, but we're having
it is very cold.
We're having tons of fun.
Not gonna lie, I had a moment talking to Lenny Kravitz. It was like, oh, okay.
I did too, cool. with Jennifer Lopez. She hugged me and I was like, oh my God, she's hugging me.
That's
I don't know
so
what to
cool.
do. That was amazing.
So be sure to check out Shotgun Wedding January 27th on Prime Video. And closing us out, we have Edwin McCain singing I'll Be. Bye, guys. Thank you so much for joining us.
Adios.
You ready? Oh, okay.
The strands in your eyes, the color them wonderful, stab me, steal my breath. And emeralds from mountains thrust towards the sky, never revealing their depth. And tell me that we belong together, dress it up. The trappings of love, I'll be captivated. I'll hang from your lips to stare on the gallows of heartache that hang from above. And I'll be better when I'm older. And I'll be the greatest fan of your life. And rain falls angry on the tin roof as we lie awake in my bed. You're my survival, you're my living proof. My love is alive, not dead. Tell me that we belong together. Dress it up with the trappings of love. I'll be captivated, I'll hang from your lips. Stared on the gallows of heartache that hang from above. And I time. And I'll be better when I'm older. I'll be the greatest fan of your life. Yet I dropped down, burned up, found my way back from the dead.
We asked our chief taste tester to try our new Bodyarmor light flavors. New flavor number 1. New flavor number 2. Number 2 for the win.
I swear I must have spent a thousand nights looking for somebody who could hold me tight until I realized I am the love of my life. I am the love of my life.